أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على خاتم نبينا والمرسلين محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحابته أجمعين ومن استنى سنتهم واهتدى بهديهم وتبعهم بخير وإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد we continue our talking about Al-Kabaer, the major sins and we start today about denying or neglecting the Hajj, not going to Hajj. If some person he can go to Hajj and he did not go to Hajj and he have the ability to go. So Hajj is a duty that as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in the hadith about the pillars of Islam, شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله إقام الصلاة إيتاء الزكاة وحج البيت وصوم رمضان. So the Hajj is one of the pillars of Islam, this duty. And Hajj is duty only for the one who can do it, who have the ability to travel and have enough money to support. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said a strong hadith about warning those people who don't do Hajj. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من ملك زادا وراحلة تبلغه حج بيت الله الحرام ولم يحج فلا عليه أن يموت يهوديا أو نصرانيا. The one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him enough money and transportation to go to Hajj and he did not, then he can die as Jew or Christian. He can die as Jew or Christian, even if he's doing Salah, even if he's giving Zakah, even if he's doing fasting, Siyam Ramadan, and he did not do Hajj and he can do it, then he can die as Jew or Christian. And Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, I wanted to send one man to all of the Islamic states to tell them, to tell me about who is not doing Hajj, to take the jizya from them because they are not Muslims. And the hadith that we said before about zakah, Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he said that anyone who have the ability to do Hajj and he did not, and he have enough money that he should give zakah and he did not give the zakah, he will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to return to dunya after death. So someone told him, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ ابْنَ Abbas, only the kafirs, they ask for returning. So Abdullah ibn Abbas said, it is in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ فَيَقُولَ رَبِّ لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ فَأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. This ayah, spend from what we have given you before the time of your death come, and then you say, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to postpone your death time for some time until you give the money that you have not been given. The same for the one who did not give the zakah money and the one who did not spend the money for going to Hajj. فَأَصَّدَّقَ, to give the zakah, وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ, mean to do the Hajj. What made Hajj duty for someone is to have, as we said, money and transportation. Enough money and transportation. Enough money for food and for living in Hijaz, the place of Hajj, and transportation to go and come back. And Sa'id ibn Jubayr, rahimahullah, one from the Tabi'een, he said, my neighbor, he died and he did not do Hajj. So I did not pray janazah on him because he knew that he could have done Hajj. He had the ability to do, but he did not. Then he said, I did not pray janazah on him. He did not consider him as Muslim because this Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. So it is very important to give priority to this. Yes, it is not a duty to do every year. No, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one man asked him, when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about Hajj, he told him, every year, Ya Rasulallah, afi kulli amin, Ya Rasulallah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not reply to him. He said again, every year, Ya Rasulallah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not reply to him. He said again, every year, Ya Rasulallah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if I said yes, it will be duty. قال لو قلت نعم لوجبت وما استطعت. If I said yes, it will be duty and you will not be able to do it. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam want to teach us, as long as Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not say about something duty, we should not ask. Just take it as it is. And how many times the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made Hajj? Only one time. One time in his life the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made Hajj. So the Hajj is duty to make only one time. One time in your life you'll make Hajj. And this is the duty Hajj. And about as long as Hajj is duty only for one time in your life when you can, so when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can punish you because you did not do Hajj. If it happened that in some year you have been a rich man and the year after year comes and you don't have the intention of doing Hajj, or you just did not specify a time, inshallah one day I will do Hajj, and year after year comes and the time of Hajj comes and every year, no, this year I'm busy, and if you want you will go but you did not go, then this what the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about him, he can die as Jew or Christian. But for example, if one person is preparing, inshallah I will not go this year but next year I will go, so he have the money this year but he said I will go next year, but he's planning, if he died before next year, This person is not the one who died as you are Christian, because he was planning to do it. And it is called in fiqh, فَرْضٌ عَلَى التَّرَاخِي, mean that it is duty without a specific time. Not like salah, not like siyam. Salah you have to do in time. Siyam you have to do in time. Zakah you have to give in time because it is every year. But Hajj you have to do only once in your life. And it is available to do, it is available to do it once every year. The month of Hajj is Shawwal, Dhul Qa'dah, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Those are the months of Hajj. Mean that the months you can start Hajj. Okay? But the last things of Hajj, the most important days of Hajj, are the day of Arafah, 9th of Dhul Hijjah. The day of Eid, 10th of the Hajj. And there are priorities. First, you have to do Hajj for yourself before you do Hajj for any other person. So if you have money, you have enough money to go to Hajj, and your father, for example, he did not go to Hajj. You say, I want to make Hajj for my father. And you have not done Hajj for yourself. No, it is, you cannot do Hajj for someone before you do your own Hajj. And very important thing here, if your father died and your father was a poor man, your father was a rich man, wealthy, and he had many chances to do Hajj and he did not and he died, then your father is in a great danger. He's in a great danger and he may have azab in his qabr. And there is a chance for him, if someone do this Hajj for him, to release him from this punishment. In case that your father was, your father or mother was wealthy, and many years came and he was healthy enough and wealthy enough to do Hajj, and he did not, or she did not. Then this is a great danger. And he may or she may having Adab al-Qabr. And this is dangerous. The other, then this person who died, he have a loan. He have a loan that has to be paid. The same as the one who died before completing his Siyam. So you have to pay the fidya for him, for these days from his money, as we said yesterday. And the one who died before giving his zakah, then you should give the zakah that he have not been given from his money before it is divided. And the one who died before doing Hajj, this is a loan, has to be paid. The other condition is that your father was poor, or he was very sick, and he never had the ability to go to Hajj. He was dreaming that he may one day be able to go to Hajj, but he never had enough money to go to Hajj. He was wishing, hoping, dreaming that one day he will go to Hajj. Every day when the Hajj time come, he make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him the ability to go to Hajj, but he could not, because he did not have enough money, or he was very sick. He could not go there, travel this long distance and be there in the crowd, because Hajj is very difficult. So, and he died. So it was not duty for him to go to Hajj when he was alive. And it is not alone in his neck after he died. So you don't have to do Hajj for him, because there is no danger for him for not doing Hajj, because when he was alive, he did not have the ability, or did not have the means to go to Hajj. So for the first condition, that we mentioned, the father or the mother, he was wealthy and was rich and he had many chances to go, and he did not go, or she did not go, then this person need to be saved. So for you, if you want to do Hajj for them, you have to do Hajj for yourself first. You have to do Hajj for yourself first, and then you do for them. And as we said before, alhamdulillah, now there is an institute in an office inside Al-Haram Al-Makki, inside the Masjid Al-Haram. There is office called Al-Hajj Bil-Inaba. Al-Hajj Bil-Inaba. Hajj agency. Hajj by agency. You are doing Hajj. You are there. And you want someone to do Hajj for your father, because some people think to do Hajj for someone, you have to be his son. No. Any Muslim can do Hajj for any other Muslim. So you go to this office, but of course before the days of Hajj. So you should go to this office before the first of Dhul Hijjah, or at least before the fifth of Dhul Hijjah. The brothers in this office, they do. There is a lot of students in Mecca who study Sharia. And you go there and give them a name. I want someone to do Hajj for this person. The name of your father, the name of your mother, the name of your grandfather, whoever. And you pay an amount of money, about 5,000 riyal or something. Those are the expenses of transportation and food for one person to do Hajj. Okay? And you give them this money, and you give them the name, and they give you a receipt. And this means that one student who are studying in Mecca, who is studying Sharia, will do Hajj for this person that you have given the name. If you want for two people, you pay and register two people. For five people, for 10 people, no problem. So this way, you don't have to come to do Hajj for yourself and come again next